So we're going to learn how to graph this function. This time, the quadratic function has a negative a value, which means that our graph should open downward. It should look like an upside down U, okay? And that's all because that coefficient of x squared, again, is a negative value. As you can see, I'm rewriting the quadratic function. And if you look closely, where it's y equals negative x squared. So negative 1 is the a coefficient of x squared. So our graph will open downward. So first step is to find the x value of the vertex. We can do that with the formula negative b over 2a. So sub in the value for b, which is 2. That's the coefficient of x. And in the denominator, we sub in for a, the value of the coefficient of x squared, which was negative 1. And just carry out the simple arithmetic here. So once we begin this simplify here, it's negative 2 over negative 2, which gives us a x value of 1 at the vertex. So our x value of the coordinates is going to be 1. And now we just have to find the y value of the vertex. So what I'll be doing shortly is substituting 1 in for x into our quadratic function. And when I get the y value, then I'll know the when I get the answer for y, I'll have the y value for the vertex. Okay, so just waiting for that to happen here. As you might already know, oh, there we go. I record these before doing the voiceover. So here, what I'm doing, again, is substituting the x value of the vertex in order to get the y value of the vertex. So carry out the arithmetic here. I take 1 squared and take the opposite of that. It's negative 1. 2 times 1 is 2. So I have negative 1 plus 2 minus 3, which should come out to negative 2. So that's the y value of my vertex. So now I know the coordinates. I know the ordered pair of the vertex. It's going to be 1, negative 2. That is the point at which my graph is going to reach a top height, because it's opening downward. That's going to be the height of my graph. So I'm going to graph that. That's going to be the top of my graph, my vertex. At this point, all I have to do is set up a table of values and evaluate for several different values of x, and then plot all the ordered pairs that I get. And I'll be able to graph the rest of my function. So here I am setting up a table of values. And what I want to do is get several values of x on either side of my vertex value. So you'll notice that my vertex value of 1 is directly in the middle, okay? So I'll use 0 and negative 1, and I'll also use 2 and 3. So I've already filled out the y value for when x is 1, because we already know it. It's negative 2 because that's the vertex we just found. So let me sub in for negative 1 for x and find out my y value when x is negative 1. And it's negative 6. So when I sub in for 0, I didn't show the work, but if you sub in for 0, it's pretty easy. Obviously, you're just left with negative 3. You're only left with the c value when you sub in 0 for x. So y is negative 3 when x is 0. So now I'll sub in for 2. So when x is 2 in this function, then y is negative 3. Just one more ordered pair, and we'll plot the rest of the function. We'll sketch the graph. Just subbing in for 3 now as the value of x. And after I evaluate, here I have 3 squared, and I take the opposite of that, so it's negative 9. 2 times 3 is 6, minus 3, all that is negative 6. So when x is 3, y is negative 6. So now I'll just plot all of my ordered pairs to sketch the graph. Okay, so here I am plotting negative 1 and I can't see that value, but it appears to be, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? Negative 1, negative 6. There's the next value. I guess that's 0 and negative 3. And now I've plotted all my ordered pairs, and now I just try to connect them as smoothly as possible. And there is the sketched graph of the function y equals negative x plus 2x minus 3. It's a beautiful thing, isn't it?